The introduction. And my name is Feng Guo from the School of Server and Hygienic Engineering in Huazhong University of Science Technology in Wuhan, China. And today I'm honored to present my work, Better Urban Management, a semantic review of multi-scale digital modeling. Today I will cover following aspects: introduction, methodology, quantitative analysis, research themes, future research directions, and conclusion. Multi-scale digital modeling is an important concept in both building information modeling and city information modeling. As we can see from the picture, the same digital models may have different levels of detail in different applications. LD refers to the representation of a 3D model with different data information, mainly concerned with the geometric details of the graphics. But in sometimes, we also concentrate on the semantic information. In both building information modeling and city information modeling, there is a similar concept of LD, but it's not limited to the graphical reading, but also includes other information. And let me show you the two LD. The first one is a level of development defined by the IFC for building information modeling. And the second one is a level of detail defined by CTGMML for the city information modeling. And for the type we can see, there are truly differences. And the level of development is more concentrated on the detailed design and the construction information of building components, while the sitting GML LD focuses more on the geometric and the semantic information of urban elements. So we have a question about this. How do we choose the LD? And for different application, we should choose which LD, LD1 or LD2? So based on this question, we defined the search database, including the Scopes, Web of Science, and the IE X-Pro, and we defined the search terms like this picture. And after following steps, we decided the filing papers and started following 12 kilograms of information. And we did a bibliometry analysis. And I will show you the results. First is the countries. And we found that scholars from China and Germany have published a large number of research papers in this field. See from the tab, the scholars with more publications are from countries with higher GPT. It seems that economic and urbanization rates are more interesting in this research topic. At least for China, we do need to find a better tool for better urban management. The next is journals and conference. As we can see, the SPS Journal of Photometric and Advanced Engineering Informatics and Automation in Conjunction are favored by the scholars. Many scholars also choose to attend the 3D Journal Information Conference to present research findings. And we found that there are two main research themes. The first one is a building or urban digital design. The second one is a building or urban management. And from the two pictures, we can see the building modeling has truly difference between the urban compared to the urban modeling. So in the following, I will detail the main topics from the pictures. The first one I want to share with you is the geometric reconstruction. Scholars use different data sources, like images, needle, with different software platforms, like SketchUp, Revit, to reconstruct tuning buildings into LD or LD two or three models. And here is an example. The squirrels capture multiple video images from a building, and then they used the deep learning machine to segment faces and openings from the building. They recovered the power cloud from structural from motion, and then they, based on the plant cloud data, they generated the LD2 model. And finally, they matched the LD2 model and the plant cloud to generate the LD3 model. And in this field, many other scholars use similar steps to reconstruct a building in the digital models. And the second one I want to share with you is a geometric simplification. Scholars use various methods like railway triangulation, video department simplification, and mesh simplification to simplify terrains and building envelopes. And here is an example. This paper, scholars covered high poly 3D building models into both simple and rational presuming no poly meshes. As we all know, the high detailed information digital modeling with detailed information, but it will increase the computational cost. So sometimes, if the application is not need the detailed information, or is not for the large scale application, so we don't need the detailed information, or in other means, we don't need the LOD3 or LOD4 model, we just need the LOD2 model is enough. And the third one I want to share with you is the geometric parameterization. The scholars research on the composition from beam to knowledge graphs by defining different constructors and identifying relationships between couplers to convert beam into knowledge graph. And in this paper, the scholars extracted the information from the beam model and into the Excel. And based on the information in Excel, they construct the knowledge graph. And in this way, they can greatly reduce the huge efforts in human or manual efforts in the experimentation. And these three topics belongs to the digital building or urban design. For the building or urban management, I only want to share with you is urban energy management. As we can see from the picture, the higher LOD model, like the LOD4, with detailed information, it with information, while the LD2 model is with less information. But if you want to do a large urban energy management or simulation, LD4 will increase the computational cost, but LD2 is enough for the energy simulation. So in the past, many scholars have used the LD2 model for single building simulation, but and they proposed the LD2.5, LD2+ for the energy simulation. But nowadays, they found LD2 is also maybe suitable for the large scale urban building energy simulation. They found the results from LD2 is far away from the LD4 get. So they want a new definition of LD for the energy simulation. So they proposed the LD2ES, which means LD2 for energy simulation. They added the necessary information like internal geometry, roof details, and make the LD2ES is more suitable for the large-scale urban building energy simulation. So we have a question. What information is needed for the urban energy management? And where there will be LD2ES+ or LD2ES++ in the future? As we all know, energy is important issues from what was what. And nowadays, the renewable energy is furnished around the world. So in the future, we don't need to concentrate the traditional energy. Maybe we need to concentrate more about the renewable energy. And we can see from the future, the share of renewable energy in total final energy consumption is low in many countries, including the developed energy and the developing energy. The potential of renewable energy is far from being realized, with Western renewable energy resources yet to be developed. Urban players need to consider how to develop and manage renewable energy to respond flexibly to different situations. So at this time, the multi-scale digital modeling is needed. And the future is coming. And let me introduce a work we have done. We have conducted a study on graph database for urban distributed ferroviaric systems. And in this database, we only considered four main data: the buildings, the distributed PV systems, the energy systems, and the weather. First, we used the direct triangulation to calculate the relationship between the buildings. We used the footprint of the buildings and calculate the distance between the buildings. Second, we used the previous soil package in the pattern. We calculated the inter-building energy dependence. The energy dependence, it means that the buildings shadows. If we have done a test in China, if one of the PV panels is obscured by the shadow, then the whole PV system cannot generate electricity at the moment. So although many scholars have calculated the PV or the solar energy potential in a region, but they do not use the PV systems in the reality, so it's important. And in your measurement, we can calculate this energy dependence relationship. And based on the data, based on the relationship, we can concentrate the knowledge graph of the urban distributed PV system. And the users can quickly obtain the shading relationship between buildings, the electricity demand of the building, and the electricity generation of the PV systems, so that it's possible to regulate the regional energy more efficiently. And this work is published in our latest publication. So if you are interested, you can see this one after the meeting. And we believe the whole process for the energy urban energy management ran like this. First, use the needle, photogrammetry, and metrics to reconstruct the multi-scale digital modeling. Second, apply the geometric simplification, detailing, and parameterization to amend the MSDM. Then, based on the MSDM, you can calculate the parameters like the energy demand, energy conservation, solar power production, and so on. And at that time, you can develop algorithms to rationally plan the distributed energy generation system, energy storage system, and the recreation of energy use in this region. Finally, feedback the obtained information back into the MSDM to update it. And in summary, the research seems related to MSDM are two major categories: digital building or urban design, and sustainable building or urban management. Geometric framework, BIM and GIS, FC2-CDG-MML, geometric reconstruction, simplification, detailing, geometric parameterization, and urban planning and design, urban resource management, are all ones directions for future research. And energy is the most frequently concerned by scholars at this time. In the future, we come to unify the distributed energy generation system, energy storage system, and the building and infrastructure in one system, achieve the optimal distribute of energy, give full play to the potential of renewable energy. And finally, the MSDM can contribute to achieving the September Development Goal 6, September Development Goal 7 and September Development Goal 11. Besides energy-related issues, urban water, transportation, and the waste resource can all be managed through the reconstruction, abandonment, conclude, update process. And that's all. Thank you.